We have three separate drinking water taps in our village. One tap is for upper caste people, two are for lower caste people. Even the different lower caste groups don't use the same taps.
In the past, Dalits were not offered curd in houses of upper caste people who believed then their buffaloes would die. They only offered food with salt and chili to the Dalits. After eating, Dalits had to clean their plates with water. Then the non-Dalits ritually purified the plate with cow urine and left them outside for another 5 days. If a wedding procession was walking to the groom's house and a Dalit came along, the guest would warn each other to stay away from him and step aside. Dalits working for non-Dalits would never earn more than 1 kg of grain per day. For generations, we learned that our lives are like this and we did not dare to change anything.
Still, discrimination has not disappeared completely. In the past 3 years, WFP and GIZ have constructed roads, toilets, irrigation channels and water ponds. Now, we even have biogas. Two years ago, GIZ introduced learning centers. Since I have never gone to school, everything I know now, I learned in the learning center.
I myself am Dalit. In my working areas, the main problem for Dalits is that they are poor. They do not have much land for growing food, so they must depend on others. Discrimination is deep-rooted in our society. Dalits are afraid to break with these traditions. They are even afraid to enter a non-Dalit's house because of what they imagine he might say or do. They do not dare to enter temples because they believe that the gods will punish them if they do. We go to different villages and unite people, for example, in learning centers. Learning centers were established in many villages. There we discuss and find solutions to problems like alcoholism, poverty, and untouchability. Then we prioritize the problems and decide on how to move forward. Do you have any worries?
Even today, people are still not completely equal. I still must show special respect to non-Dalits, even if they are much younger than me.
Why don't you try to find solutions in the learning center? You could make an action plan and change the situation step by step. In our discussion, we have identified the following problem. How can we stop the remaining discrimination?
What do you think about everybody eating together?
What do you mean by everybody eating together?
I mean, all the women, men, and everybody from the village cooks and eats together, no matter what their caste is.
I don't mind if you go, but I will not eat there.
But all humans are the same. There is no difference between us. Let us eat together.
She is right. We should end our ancestors' tradition of not eating food touched by Dalits. We should work hand in hand to develop our country.
Even though we Dalits have no access to good education, we are very skilled. It is time to show us the respect that we deserve.
After sharing our ideas, most of us agree that we all, Dalits and non-Dalits, should sit and eat together.
Come on, let's make a work plan and decide who takes responsibility for what.
GIZ supported Dalits a lot to achieve equality and to end discrimination. The tradition was made by older people, not by God. God does not discriminate. The discussion at the learning center changed the views of people.
Over time, people began to gain awareness. Young people wanted to modernize the village and gradually took over responsibility. Young people do not care about the concept of Dalits and non-Dalits.
We young people want everybody to see that in this village, caste discrimination is ending. In our village, we are not going to force anyone to eat tomorrow or to do anything else. We want them to do it from their own free choice. We support this eating together because we want our message to be heard by the politicians at the central level.
We are cutting these vegetables to prepare food for the eating together tomorrow. Dalits and non-Dalits will eat together to end discrimination.
Now we have stayed together with the Dalits in the learning centers for 2 years.
There, we understood that we are all the same. We are all human.
Treating them badly was a bad tradition from ancient times. No matter who gets cut, everybody's blood is red. Yet in the past, I was afraid. At the end of the day, it's my community, and we all live together. Today, I am not afraid anymore. I wish that the remaining injustice would disappear soon. I hope that many people in Bajhang and in the whole country hear about our eating together.
सरकारले कुरती घोषणा गरिसक्यो तर के व्यवहारा छ त छैन कोही पनि मान्छे जन्मदै शूद्र वा ब्राह्मण हुँदैन छुवाछुतको विरुद्धको कुरा संविधानले लेखिसकेको 2021 सालदेखि मुनिको यसले लेखिसक्यो तर पनि हाम्रो दिमागभित्र बसेको अलिअलि कस कसिङ्गर भन्छौँ नि हामी हो त्यस्तो खालको विकृति विसङ्गति अलिअलि बाँकी छ त्यसलाई हामी आजको दिनदेखि हटाउँ
I feel very happy about the eating together. Before I worked for GIZ, we only talked about changes. Now, we are really putting into action what we are talking about. We go to the villages and motivate people. That is the key to success.
Being Dalit myself, I've had many different experiences while working in the field. When I started to facilitate learning centers, people asked me to sit outside while eating food. Slowly, people became more sensitive and the same people came to understand that it is wrong to treat others that way. Nowadays, everybody welcomes me into their house. But outside of my working areas, I find the situation of Dalits is still the same as ever. In my working areas, especially in those with learning centers, the living conditions of Dalits are much better.
Today, we all drink from the same water tap. We all sit together. We are happy together.
I hope that all brothers and sisters in Bajhang see our eating together as an example. I would like people to understand that we, the uneducated women of Moyal, ate food cooked by Dalits. So far, nothing bad has happened to us. Instead, our village is developing. So why should we discriminate? I hope that the living standards of Dalits in other villages will rise as it did here.
I would like to openly say that discrimination should end. I would like to see everyone as one. I would like to see all the people in the district sitting and laughing together and everyone being treated equally. I would like everyone in Bajhang to live together as one caste. Bajhang chuma mile